हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑन द इनकम टैक्स केसेस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यू ऑन सेक्शन 56 सबसेक्शन 2 क्लॉज 7B. द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सेक्शन 56 सबसेक्शन 2 क्लॉज 7B ब्रॉडली गिव्स द आउटलाइन दैट व्हेन ए पर्सन परचेजेस ए प्रॉपर्टी एंड द परचेज consideration and the stamp duty valuation does not collide with each other, or meaning thereby that the stamp duty valuation is more than the purchase consideration, in that case the difference between the purchase consideration and the stamp duty valuation should be taken as income of the person who is purchasing the property. But there is a proviso to section 56 subsection 2 clause 7B that if the date of agreement and the date of the registration of the document is different, then the stamp duty valuation of that property may be taken as on the date of agreement. This issue has been taken by the Honorable ITAT D bench in the case of Shyam Kumar Madhav Das Chugh versus Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax International Taxation, and this matter has been reported in 109 ITR Tribunal Short Notes 49. The matter has been decided on 8th January 2024. The facts of the case are little bit different. In this case, the assessment year is related to assessment year 14-15. The assessee entered into a purchase agreement to purchase a property in the financial year 10-11, and in the financial year 10-11 the stamp duty valuation was 1.82 crore. This agreement to purchase materialized into the registered document in the financial year 13-14, when the stamp duty increased up to 2,22,45,000. In nutshell, thus there was a difference of rupees 40,45,000 in the stamp duty valuation on the date of agreement to purchase and on the date of registration of the document. The moot question in this case was that for the purpose of applying section 56 subsection 2 clause 7 clause B, whether the stamp duty valuation on the date of agreement to purchase or on the date of registration of the document should be taken. The proviso to section 56 subsection 2 clause 7B broadly says that if the some consideration has been paid at the time of agreement to purchase by check or by the banking notes, then the stamp duty valuation on the date of agreement to purchase may be taken. But when the assessment proceedings were going on, the learned assessing officer, by taking this may word, made an addition of rupees 40,45,000. That was the difference between the stamp duty valuation on the date of the purchase and on the date of the registration of the document, by interpreting the section that the may word should go in favor of the department. But the assessee was saying that when there is a interpretation of a section or a proviso which goes both in favor of the department and both in and also in favor of the department, that interpretation should be taken which is beneficial to the assessee. But the assessing officer go ahead with the addition. CIT appeal also appealed the order of the learned assessing officer. When this matter came to the tribunal, tribunal said that the proviso to section 56 subsection 2 clause 7B gives a clear mandate that the stamp duty valuation on the date of agreement to purchase should be taken. The main condition for taking the stamp duty valuation on the date of the agreement to purchase is that some consideration should have been paid by check before the registration of the document take place, because in the present case some consideration was paid by check. So all the conditions of section 56 subsection 2 clause 7B was met in this case. Friends, this case is very important, at least in those cases where the assessee feels that there will be a more time lag between the agreement to sell or agreement to purchase and the date of the registration of the sale deed. So in that case, the assessee should try to give some consideration by check at the time of making the agreement. The benefit of this will be that he can suppose in those cases, if the stamp duty value increases in the records of the government, the assessee can take the benefit of lesser stamp duty value as on the date of the agreement to purchase. At the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Shyam Kumar Madhav Das Chugh versus Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, International Taxation. And this case has been reported in 109 ITR Tribunal Short Notes 49. The matter has been decided by Honorable ITIT Delhi D Bench and the date of the judgment is 8th January 2024. Thank you, friends.